watch those cringy school romance animes in holidays so you get motivated to start contracting your real life waifu. So you hit the gym and start improving yourself. You made progress, now you're confident. Say, this year I will get bitches falling on me. School starts.
Oh shit.
Almost nothing changed. You got a new crush. She's not noticing you. Probably got a boyfriend. But now that creepy 2 out of 10 ugly ass bitch is looking at you. So you get demotivated and depressed.
Why the fuck should I even work out for? I'm not 6 foot and I'm brown.
Hello, your computer has virus.
I don't have a cute face and curly hair and I'll never be able to get bitches.
Shut up. Look at Bucky. Bucky isn't the most good looking man. He's 5'6". But he can still get any pussy he wants. He knows that being cute isn't gonna get him women. But being masculine will. So he provides, he protects, and he looks masculine as fuck.
If you're like me, you probably wondered, why can't I get bitches even though I've been hitting the gym and improving my looks? Whoa. Gotta understand your sexual market value as a man. Now I'm gonna explain it using this graph. So let's say you're in high school between 15 and 20 years old. Your value as a man is low.
But why?
Because you literally don't have life yet. You're living with your parents. You don't have that business. You don't have fame or status or respect from people and build that 10 out of 10 physique or bought a car and a house. And you can't provide for your women. And these things what makes your sexual market value high as a man. You have none of them. So basically, pussy, growing up, you got nothing that'll make women chase you for. But for the girls in your class, their value is peaking. Because they start getting thick, taking care of their looks, which is the main factor in their sexual market value. Think of it, you're not attracted to some bitch because she got a Lamborghini and the respect from other men. So literally every man, even the creepy 60 years old adults, find them attractive and chase them. And you might say,
tall skinny shots are getting all the pussy then.
Whoa, we're still young and dumb. We don't think about future. We don't think in decades. So the girls in your class will only rate you on your looks and maybe your status, aka the respect you get from your friends and shit. So basically those genetically gifted chads become high value men in high school because they have a lot of friends, they get respect from them, they got a 9 out of 10 face and they might have started hitting the gym and improving their looks. But girls don't even realize this. If you ask them why they're attracted to that 9 out of 10 shad, they will say,
oh, he's cute and funny and
shut up. So those shads might look high value to you, but in reality, when high school ends, they're still pussies. Now, since the girls in high school value is peaking, bitches only look upwards. So even that 3 out of 10 ugly ass bitch is only attracted to that 8 out of 10 shad. Why wouldn't she? She got too many options. Cause every motherfucker in your age is horny as fuck. And social media fucked this shit more. Before the internet only had a small group of men to compete with to get your crush. But now you're competing with David Laid looking motherfuckers on Instagram. And here where it gets depressing, 5 out of 10 boys or less not getting any interaction from women. Feel depressed and demotivated in life because one of their biggest goals is to attract that 10 out of 10 women. That's one of our biggest desires, but social media and porn fuck that desire. See your dream women hanging out with that 10 out of 10 rich motherfucker, or see motherfuckers simping on her in the comments, or even worse, you see her getting fucked by a fucking chat.
Oh my god, stop bro, I'm stuck!
So you feel pathetic and weak, start coping.
I will never be able to attract her.
So you start fapping to her.
Oh shit, here we go again.
Even worse, lower your expectations, go chase that 2 out of 10 girl.
Oh, it's better than fapping, bro.
Shut up. I've been there. I've got a no pussy. I was a fat ass nerdy shy all through middle school. And I'm so grateful for it. Because your motherfuckers need to understand this concept called the male advantage.
This YouTuber, First Man, talks about it.
We, as men, our value peaks later in life. Because if we work on ourselves, build that business that will create us passive income and maximize our looks, by the time we get to 30, we'll probably be having a 10 out of 10 physique, looking at least a 7 out of 10 in face-wise, because you weren't a dumbass and actually drained your neck, so your jawline can pop more and did some jawline exercises or whatever. And you can even get herb transplants because you're now having at least 10k per month passive income. And this is what makes your sexual market value spikes. This is what makes you the top 1% of male. These motherfuckers get all the attraction from girls. The 10 out of 10s, the 8 out of 10s, the 3 out of 10s. It doesn't matter. But most people don't get there because every man in their youth is dumb. We don't understand that our sexual market value peaks later in life. We think that these years are the best years in our life because every motherfucker told us, enjoy your 20s and teenage or you will regret it. So you go fuck around, play video games, binge anime,
stop the cap,
chase women, go to parties. Now you get to university, maybe get into a serious relationship, end up working a shitty 9-to-5 job. Well, it depends on your grades or whatever. It's still shit though. So you make enough money, decide to marry your girlfriend or whatever. So you fucked up your way to the male advantage for two reasons. First, you got no time and money. You got no time to hit the gym, maximize your looks. Even if you know how to start an online business, you don't have the time and money to invest that business because you got responsibility now. You got kids to take care of.
We go again.
Provide for them. Pay their school bills. You might buy a cringy ass family car or even a house on death. So you fucked up. Hi, this is me from the future. That dumbass motherfucker couldn't even remember 2 points in a fucking video.
You stupid.
And the second reason they feel that they have achieved their purpose in life, because we as men are always chasing freedom. So when they get a family, have a job that already pays the bill, we feel like we achieved our purpose, aka planting our tree in the world. So they get complacent. Why would they want to become financially free, travel around the world? Why would they improve their looks to attract that 10 out of 10 women? They already got the women now. Even if they have another goals, why would they achieve them? They know that the only thing they have to do is to maintain that job. It's like making gains in the gym and then maintaining your gains. They do the same thing. They don't want to get on steroids, take risk, and make more gains. So they settle. So you live the average life. You continue doing your shitty 9-to-5 job till you get to 60. Now you actually paid the bills. Only now, you're retired, can enjoy your life. But last time I checked, those motherfuckers got back problems, got mental health problems, got bored of their women, maybe even divorced. And even worse, got sent to a retirement house by their children. So basically, not being able to attract an okay girlfriend is amazing because you don't have the risk to live that average shitty life. Instead, work on yourself. Get to the male advantage as fast as possible so you can attract your 10 out of 10 dream women and live the best life you can live. And I'm 100% sure that the best way to get to the male advantage is to start self-improvement the Bucky way. Where we improve every pillar of our life. We improve our finances by working towards our purposeful business. Improve our looks, our mental health, our knowledge, relationships. This will get you to the 0.1% alpha males. Actually, enjoy your journey to the male advantage and be happy along the way. So you don't end up like those fat, depressed, wish motherfuckers. Watch this video where we're gonna use school to help us start our self-improvement journey. And as always, there's no time when you're ready to take action.